All right. Good afternoon, Tuesday. Good afternoon, M2uesday. How's everybody doing this fine Tuesday evening? I'm Rick, and you are watching the Whole Lot of Zep Diecast channel. And welcome aboard. So what I'm going to do is, Gary from Gary's Diecast had presented a challenge, which is 10 to 15 cars, and they're just random cars from your collection. They could be your most favorite cars, they could be your least favorite cars, but it's a minimum of 10 and a maximum of 15. Outside of that, it's whatever your little heart desires. So I decided I was going to kill two birds with one stone, and I was going to do the challenge, but I'm going to present it in M2 format. Just a second. I apologize for that. Three of the castings that I'm going to show, I just cracked open for this video. And like I said, this is an M2 format, so everything that's going to be shown is M2. I do have a whole bunch of cars, just like a lot of you guys do as well, that you can show, but I figured... because it's M2uesday for me, because that's what I present on Tuesdays, this would be the most opportune time to crack a couple cars. And the copyright dates back to 2008 on one of them. And this is before they put acrylic lids on their diamond plate plinths. It still came on the plinth, you just didn't get the acrylic case that goes with it. You can see the craftsmanship. There's quite a bit of a difference between then and what some of the stuff that they're pumping out now, and it's a shame. Alright, 3 minutes wasted on babble. Let's just get right down to it. Alright. First up, I'm going to show... Actually, two that I'm going to show are staying in their boxes, because it's just... You'll see why in a second. It's just too difficult trying to... open everything up and try to display it. So... what I have here is the 1958 Chevy Cameo truck and a 1970 Chevelle SS 454. When I saw M2 put this one out in an advertisement that they do on their channel, I started chomping at the bit when I saw the Chevelle. I was like, there's no way I'm missing this one. Love that color scheme. It's just so cool. I know some of you aren't crazy about the delivery on them. I understand that. I can appreciate it. It would be nice if they were just clean cut with no sprite tags on the doors or anything, but it's really not that bad. It's tastefully done. What they could have done almost would have looked like this 73 Cheyenne 10 pulling a 70 Chevelle SS 454, barn find. How cool is that? See, they could have done the whole Sprite thing in that color scheme with that Cheyenne. Oh well. It still looks good on this set anyway. Alright, so I guess you guys can understand why I'm not taking them out of the boxes. It's just... You can see them just fine in there. Alright, so what I got next is a 59 VW microbus with the Maui and Sons livery. That I collect. I like the Maui and Sons livery. I have a couple pieces. The Jeep's one of them. And I have a box truck, and I think it might be a Studebaker. I can't remember, but it's a Maui and Sons set. Next, I have a 50 Oldsmobile 88. My Rocket 88. All right, up next I have a 57 Ford Fairlane 500. I'd like to see M2 do more of the older castings like this. I mean, this is a good example. I mean, those doors drive me nuts. I love the color pattern on it. It's beautiful. The white walls, it's such a beautiful looking car. I mean, the doors, eh. Still a cool piece, nonetheless. Up next, I have the 54 Chevy Bel Air. Next on the hit list is a 55 Chevy Bel Air. Next up, 58 Chevy Impala. Next, I have the 68 Barracuda Hemi Super Stock from the Bootlegger series. Up next, I have a 69 Camaro Copo Moon Eyes.
First of all, look, we're sorry we're a bit late, judging by that toilet roll, somebody's had diarrhea. That should do as an excuse for that. But the other thing is that Jimmy's got a guitar strap that's made of cement, and it's great. Yeah, his guitar has had a bit of an accident, but we got it fixed now, so he had to use his other guitar, which you can appreciate, fell apart. This is a song from Houses of the Holy. It's just about the journey that we're all on. That's one guy who's not on the same journey.
All right. What I have next is going to start a theme. And it's not what you think it is. What I have next is a 69 Plymouth Roadrunner 440 six-pack, also a Moon Eyes. And this is for Mike Dyson. Wheels, my buddy, if you happen to be watching this, look at those wheels, man. Doesn't that just drive you nuts? That's just wrong, isn't it, Mike? Ah, you know I'm just messing with you, buddy. If you're watching. I don't want to assume you are. Mike Dyson has a thing about wheels. He's like the wheel swap master. And they all have to match. And if they don't match, it drives them nuts. So, in jest, I had to point that out to him. All right. Up next. '69 Plymouth Roadrunner A12, the airlift hood. There, that is just the bare bones, raw horsepower Roadrunner. I don't even think that had an AM radio in it. I think that was part of the delete package. And the GTX is on the same frame, it's basically the same car, except it has a little more creature comforts. Called the Gentleman's Roadrunner, the GTX, that is. All right, there it is, 446 with the A12 body, the airlift hood. All right. After this one, I'm sure you guys will figure out what's going on. What I have up here is a 69 Roadrunner. Another 446 pack. And this is one of the ones that I just cracked open today. It's been sealed since 2008. The next two, one's a 2009 and the other one's a 2010. It was a bittersweet moment. That second Roadrunner I showed with the airlift hood, that one was also a 2009, but I had to crack that one because it had one of those silicone rubber bands, and I was afraid it was going to start chewing into the paint. Fortunately, for as long as it's a big card in it, there was no issues. I've been lucky so far with the Hot Wheels black box, 100%, the ones that have the rubber bands around the hoods. I had to crack them open as well. I hate doing it, but I have to. Favorite Roadrunner because she likes that color. So up next, I have, are you ready for it? A 1969 446 pack. And it's in a metallic blue frost with a white interior. Sometimes black steel wheels just look good. This happens to be one of those times. Not many cars can pull off the steel wheels, but the Roadrunner is an exception to the rule. Of course, it looks good with the slots or the craggers, or even the mismatch wheels, Mr. Mike Dyson. All right, and up last, are you ready for it? I have a 69 Plymouth Roadrunner Hemi.
Thank you.
It's a Hemi. And this one's in white with black interior.
This is a song that came off the fourth album. It's about what could happen if you walk through the park and you get involved. It's called Mr. Mountain Hop.
M2uesday, and you got to witness three Roadrunners crack the breathing air for the very first time since 2008, 9, and 10 respectively. Well, I'd just like to thank you guys for hanging out and peeking in on me and see what I got on tap. Appreciate you guys hanging out and joining the party. As always, you guys stay safe, stay healthy, take care of one another, and I will catch you on my next video.